Lockheed Martin announced on the 16th of September that it's delivered a 300-kilowatt laser to the U.S. Defense Department that will integrate it into a U.S. Army high-energy laser demonstration later this year. The Defense Corporation has developed the laser under the Pentagon's High Energy Laser Scaling Initiative, HELSI, which is an effort to strengthen the directed energy industrial base and improve the quality and power of laser beams. Viewers may note that the Pentagon selected Lockheed in 2019 to scale its spectral beam combined high energy laser architecture to the 300 kilowatt class level as part of the HELSI effort, according to the release. The release also notes that the company completed the task ahead of schedule. Rick Cordaro, Vice President of Lockheed Martin Advanced Product Solutions, said Lockheed Martin increased the power and efficiency and reduced the weight and volume of continuous wavelength high-energy lasers, which reduces the risk for future fielding efforts of high-power laser weapon systems. In this video, Defense Updates analyzes why Lockheed Martin's delivery of a 300-kilowatt laser is an important milestone. Let's get started. This video is sponsored by the free-to-play military vehicle combat game War Thunder. We talk a lot about military vehicles on this channel, but what about trying them out for yourself? In War Thunder, you can choose from more than 1,200 playable vehicles from the 1930s to the 1990s and go to battle on more than 80 theaters of war. You can fly aircraft, helicopters, drive tanks, and command ships of all types and sizes, which have been carefully recreated from their real-world counterparts. It's available as a free download on PC, PlayStation 4, and Xbox One with cross-platform support. So grab your friends and give it a try. All viewers of Defense Updates that register using the link in the description below will also get a free premium tank, aircraft, or ship, and 3 days of premium account time as a bonus. The U.S. Defense Department is particularly interested in directed energy systems, high-energy lasers, and high-power microwaves to protect military personnel and installations from aerial threats like short-range air defense and against drones, rockets, mortar, and artillery. Lasers have some crucial advantages when compared to traditional kinetic means. The speed of light enables them to hit their targets almost instantaneously. Laser weapons also don't need to carry ammunition like traditional systems, and hence they'll be able to take out a much larger number of threats, constrained only by the power supply limit of the platform. They're also so much cheaper and could cost as little as $1 per shot. Another important aspect is that laser weapons could be used to defend against hypersonic weapons. An object is said to be hypersonic once they exceed speeds of Mach 5, that's 5 times the speed of sound. This is about 1,715 meters per second, or 3,836 miles per hour, or 6,174 kilometers per hour. Unlike subsonic and supersonic weapons, hypersonic weapons currently have no reliable counters, and laser could prove to be a solution. As per the release, the laser will support demonstrations of the Army's Indirect Fires Protection Capability High Energy Laser, IFPC HEL, which is scheduled for lab and field testing this year. The IFPC HEL program is one of the U.S. Army's 35 signature modernization priorities. The program falls under the service's Air and Missile Defense Priority Area, but is managed by the Rapid Capabilities and Critical Technologies Office. Lockheed Martin also recently delivered a 60-plus kilowatt class laser to the U.S. Navy as part of a program called High Energy Laser with Integrated Optical Dazzler and Surveillance, or Helios. The Lockheed statement said, "This recent HELSI delivery milestone also exemplifies Lockheed Martin's commitment to 21st century security, developing advanced technologies that provide speed, agility, and mission solutions that help ensure the U.S. and its allies are always prepared for what's ahead." The American military has been working to field laser weapons for a long time now. In 2010, the Air Force mounted and fired off a megawatt-class chemical laser from a modified Boeing 747. Another test with LAWS was conducted in 2014. Many projects are currently being executed to field laser weapons like SHIELD. The SHIELD program is developing a directed energy laser system that will act as a demonstrator for a self-defense system that could eventually enable aircraft to protect themselves from surface-to-air SAM and air-to-air AAM missiles. On April 23, 2019, the program successfully achieved a major goal when a laser developed as part of the program shot down several air-launched missiles in flight. The system could be deployed as an add-on pod in the future. It can be said that, along with Israel, the U.S. military is really making good progress when it comes to directed energy weapons.
Subscribe for more videos like this. Hit the like button if you find the video interesting, and kindly provide your feedback in the comment section. This will help us improve.